Hi. Today I thought it would be nice to show you how much pouring paint we can mix from a little tube from the Artesa box with 60 colors. So I'm going to mix as much pouring medium in the paint that I can get and make sure that it's still vibrant. And I thought it would be fun to do that all with you so you can see. These tubes are 22 milliliters and that's 0.74 OZ for the US. I think I can make 250 milliliter paint with it, so I already calculated that too. But we'll see. I'm just going to mix and we'll see how much paint we can make with it. And why I'm doing that is because when you buy your paints, of course it is important to know how much pouring paint you can make with it. For instance, if you buy a very cheap craft paint, maybe you can double it, but that's it. And if you have paint with very strong pigments, well, you can make a lot more paint. And then you have to ask yourself, is that little bit more expensive paint really so expensive if you can make much more volume with it? And it's about this box. There's 60 colors in it. I'll show you if you haven't seen it. Well, not everything is in it. That's because I used a lot already, but they're very beautiful colors. In the box, there are actually 60 colors, and you can imagine how much pouring paint we can make with that. And that's what we're going for, of course. And I'm really happy with the Artesa premium acrylics, because yeah, the paint is really nice, vibrant, easy to mix. That's why I love them. Okay. So what I'm going to do, this is a 250 milliliter cup, and I'm just going to empty the paint in this cup and mix my pouring medium in it. I use this time the Deco varnish. It's a matte varnish that we can buy in the Netherlands, but you can also use, of course, Flutrol or Elmer's glue or whatever you use. That doesn't really matter. And I also have the acrylic thinner. And I just add a few drops always because it's a paint booster. I think that's how you call it in the US, paint booster. It's like water, but it makes sure your paint stays elastic and the drying time will also extend, and that's good, so that will prevent to get your paintings cracked. Okay, now I'm going to empty this tube. So that is the 22 milliliters and it's called Rose. I haven't used this color, of course. This is a new tube. So, well, that looks like a very pretty color. I'm going to squish everything out of it. Okay. I have to get my pouring sticks. I forgot to get them. Make sure everything is out of my tube. You see, every time you squish, there will be a drop coming from it. Okay. Now, first, what I will do is what I normally do is do twice the amount of the pouring medium with the paint. Let's see how that works. And then I think I'm just going to add more and more and see how far we can go with mixing and still having a nice vibrant paint. As you can see, the varnish I use, it's pretty thick. You see my paint is still pretty thick. And I'm trying to get all the paint from the sides. I'm sorry, I guess my hand is in the way. I'll try to stir with my left hand. This paint looks still very nice and vibrant. I hope you can see. So now I'm going to add about half more. So now we have about 3 times the pouring medium to 1 time paint. And mix it up again. And yes, the paint is still very vibrant. So now I'm going to put in again an amount, and that will make it about, well, 4 times the amount of pouring medium to 1 part paint. And we're going to see how that looks. I'm sorry, I'm right-handed, but I know I'm in front of the camera when I do. I'm trying to get all the pouring medium from the sides. And yes, it still looks very nice, beautiful and vibrant. So I'm just going to see if I can put in an amount one more time. Yes, that looks very good. So I'm just going to fill up my cup and hope I did not dilute the paint. Now, I need to stir firmly. I think I'm going to get a bigger stick, just a minute, guys. My hand is getting tired from mixing. So as you can see, because it's not mixed well, it's a little bit more pink right now. So now it's getting less vibrant, but I haven't stirred it very well. I will do that now. And there is the vibrant color back. It's very hard to get all the pouring medium from the sides. Okay, I will show you. Well, this still looks very nice and vibrant. So I think with 1 tube from 8.45 OC, from 1 tube from 0.74 OC, we can make 8.45 OC. And I think that's a lot. And then I'm happy to tell you that Artesa paint really isn't that expensive if you compare it with the other more expensive brands, and it's really just as good. And what I like most about this box is that there are so many vibrant colors in it, so that means you can experiment with lots of colors and have lots of fun. You see, it's still nice and thick. I'm going to thin it a little bit more. And well, that is what I wanted to show you guys. So if you haven't thought about buying Artesa, it really is worth the money. And I wouldn't say that if I didn't use it myself. It's really very pretty paint that I love very much. I think Sandra Lett is also using it, and she also loves to work with it. Okay. Yeah. That looks good, but it can be a little bit more thin. Okay, so I hope I told you about how to mix paint, and that the more pigments there are in paint, the more you can mix with it, and in the end that's cheaper than using cheaper paint or craft paints, where you can only make a little because the colors will go away. Okay, I have here a 250 milliliter bottle. That's the 8.45 OC. And now I'm going to pour it in the bottle. I hope I won't spill. Normally I will use a cartonboard cup. I'm sorry, I have to be in front of you. Just a minute. I need to empty my cup. I'm sorry. And when you store your paints mixed like this in bottles with a good lid, I hope you can see, you can really keep it good for, well, at least 6 months, because I have paints in my I've paints that I mixed about 6 months ago and are still great. And maybe you need to shake it a little bit before you use it, but it's really still good, and it's a really easy way to store your paints. And it's very handy because if you want to pour, you already have your pouring paints ready, and all the air bubbles are already out because it has been waiting in your bottle for so long. Okay, I think this was a great experiment. So from this little tube, we made as much as this big bottle, so the 0.74 OC went to 8.453 OC. So I hope you like to see it, and if you like to buy the Artesa paints, all the links are below my video. If you like the video, please subscribe, give me a thumb up. Visit me on Facebook or Instagram, I really like that. And I am pouring soon for you, so I'll be back. Bye bye.